Hi guys, today for you a little overview of this very very vintage Canon laser printer I got from the garage day. It is a Canon LBP4+, and it was made, believe it or not, in 1991. So it is more than 20 years old, guys. So it was a quite a compact form factor, as you can see, but it is missing probably the paper trays at the bottom. It has the automatic image refinement, a little LCD display, and the function keys. We will have a look at them later. So sadly, it is in very bad condition. If not, if it was in good condition and complete, it would be a collectible item. It is not good enough. So here is the main toner door, toner cartridge spot here, with probably the oven in, yes, in this part. The oven is here, you can see it is inside is quite okay for such a old thing. So we have a green button here, I believe it is for setting the ink density of the paper or something like this. Okay, so I will show you the rear side, because it is interesting. At the rear, you have of course a parallel port, serial port, and a very very weird, very long plug for a video port. I have no clue of what it is for. So as you can see, made in September 1991. Laser class 1. So this part is interesting because you can pull this here. It is a user accessible part, it seems. Here is the interface PCB. As you can see, it is only a through-hole components, very basic SN74 series, very old school. And here we have something interesting. It looks like a supercomputer module almost. It is not easy to remove. Yes. This is, it seems, it is the memory module for the printer, guys, made by Kingston. It is 1 megabyte of memory. As you can see, there were spots for filling more memory, so upgrade to 2 megabytes as small clips. You could plug into the clips holders here, and there is here something else missing. I have no clue what it is. So this is really weird and unusual. Here you can guess the internal construction. It is all made in steel. And this is the font cartridge, which was plugged at the side here. The plastic housing was broken, but I was able to save inside. And in fact it is already loose, so we can have a look, a little look inside. I will not take it apart completely now, but I am just showing you. As you can see, all steel construction, very strong, a big, at least 2 large PCBs inside here. And the optical engine must be here at the bottom. So it will be really interesting to take apart. But it will be for later. So I will put it back together and I will show you the little animation and the LCD where it is powered on. So here we are. I did zoom onto the LCD display and look what happens. Camera has some focusing problems. Okay. So you can, yeah, it is very, and look, with this little animation, with a little crab. Very, very cute. I did already see it onto another Canon printer. They do not do it anymore by now. Let's do it again. So it is cute, a little crab. So it is complaining about the open door, but no, the door is not open. If I go into the menu, I have lots of options. No clue what it is. Feeder selection. Looks like it is some kind of address or something like this. Not weird. Also, menu. Layout copy cover. Copy overlay, commande initial, initial interface, interface control, save the settings, it seems. Enter. I have no clue of what it does. Centronics, it is for selecting the Centronics interface. Really obscure vintage technology. So it's quite sad. Here is not owner on the paper tray because maybe in fact it is still in working condition. I could have printed a test page. And here is one last time a little crab for you. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.